to proclaim liberty to the captives, release to the prisoners, to announce a year of favor from the Lord and a day of benediction by our God, to comfort all who mourn, to place on those who mourn in Zion a diadem instead of ashes, to give them oil of gladness instead of mourning, a glorious mantle instead of a faint spirit, the word of the Lord.
Now is the time of judgment on this world. Now the ruler of this world I am lifted up from the earth, I will draw everyone to myself. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In his funeral directives, Monsignor Snow wrote that the mission of the church is the salvation of souls. Well, you know Monsignor loved Canon Law, and it's so fitting to print in his funeral program a portion of the most important canon of the Pope. The very last canon, 1752, says that the salvation of souls is the supreme law in the church. I think understanding this helps us to make the law approachable. It's all about the salvation of souls. I ask you, was there a more approachable man than Monsignor Harris? He just loved the church law. In fact, I continued to consult him on canonical questions up until last week. He continued working for the diocese, doing canonical research, helping with marriage cases, right over the last few weeks. You see, this idea of approachability was important to him. In fact, it can be found in the readings he selected for his funeral mass. So we just heard the prophet Isaiah speaks of the Messiah to be sent to bring good news to the afflicted, to bind up the brokenhearted. Monsignor knew that in imitation of Jesus, this would often entail personal sacrifice on his part, as he would approach and accompany another. But you see, he was a farmer, and he wasn't afraid of work, hard work. He knew that unless a grain of wheat falls and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much produce. Through the grace of God, as a priest who was ever present to his people, Monsignor Snow bore an abundance of fruit for the glory of God. He genuinely enjoyed this outreach to the folks, whether it was driving a plumber truck en route to a house fire, being called to negotiate a family dispute in a potentially hostile domestic situation, running a major parish capital campaign and building a beautiful new church in Morristown, even climbing the towers of the cathedral to investigate, he says, water damage to the stonework. Even though I accused him of going up there to see how much damage he would cause by cutting down those beautiful flowering crab trees in front of the cathedral. Well, they went down, although he claimed one of the contractor's trucks got hit. My sisters and brothers, he was not afraid to enter the muck of life, get his hands dirty, and accompany our sisters. boy from Norfolk never forgot his roots. His vacations used to be spent working the hay fields on the family farm. There was nothing aloof or standoffish about Monsignor. So many people felt comfortable in approaching the church because he made them feel good about themselves. And he earnestly cared about their salvific well-being. And they knew it. His sense of humor would disarm anybody. Nevertheless, he cared. I remember one day in his office, we were working on a case where a priest decided he wanted to leave at the ministry. And I can still see Monsignor sitting at his desk, shaking his head, saying how he couldn't understand how anyone can go without the Eucharist, and for a priest not celebrating Mass. For him, the Eucharist was everything. I'm so grateful, as I know he was, to Deacon Tony for helping Monsignor celebrate Mass in his room during the pandemic. His priestly ministry never stopped once he moved into St. Joe's. Not even the pandemic could prevent his ministry to the residents at home. Before the coronavirus invaded our space, he was asked to lead a funeral service, as he was many times earlier, for one of the deceased non-Catholic residents in that man's church. Even his daily routine, down in physical therapy, became an event. It became the go-to place for residents who wanted to sway to the music that he would charge Alexa to provide. The residents loved it. The swaying was good for their bodies and good for their souls. Monsignor died on the church's birthday, Pentecost Sunday. 70 years ago today, this day of his burial, he was baptized and became a child of God. A much loved member of this family of faith that we know and follow as the church. We pray this is the day that he is born to the peace and joy of eternal life, where there is no more pain or suffering. This priest of God, for 44 years, embraced the gifts of the Holy Spirit that he received and impacted the lives of some of them. You know that Monsignor and I enjoyed many adventurous trips to Canon Law Convention. But I share just a couple with you. In those pre-GPS days, we got lost in the parking lot in Hershey, Pennsylvania. And while walking on the boardwalk, the Atlantic City, my guess was But he never got lost when it came to the code of canon law. He knew that like the back of his hand, although that it was a whole lot of good. Just a few days after 9/11, we flew out while we were preparing to go through TSA screening at the airport, he discovered a box cover in his pocket. He said he completely forgot about putting it in his pocket. You see, he had just got it the night before from an undertaker. I'm not sure if it was Bugs. He was going to use it to open boxes of candles. and try to hand that sucker off to me. While the folks in line behind us thought we were pretty suspicious by the looks we got, jumping box cutters between us. As you remember, we were all pretty jittery in airports those post-9/11 days. When I first accompanied him at Canon Law conventions, I was impressed by his studious note-taking. That is, until one day, I looked over at the notes he was taking. The only thing I did not, he wrote down were the jokes the presenter offered for the course. Then he embellished them up a bit and later claimed them as his own in a setting that works. Sometimes, even the pulpit. Of course, that was before I became a bishop. For many years, Monsignor Snow and Traverse. A whole lot of physical suffering, but he kept going. He always felt he was truly blessed by special co-workers in the tribunal office. I know how much he appreciated Sister Mary, Patrick, Sister Victorine, Diana, Gidget, special words of gratitude go out to Elaine for all her tireless support and assistance, particularly as Monsignor's health deteriorated. We are so grateful to St. Joseph's home, helping in her staff, even Tony, Judy, and other volunteers at St. Joseph's as they provided Monsignor truly heroic care. I want to thank Truth Father Jeroen for his hospitality, his outreach to Monsignor from the tribunal, and his pastoral care to Monsignor's family. I know you, Monsignor's dear friends, and many more stories that speak about his community spirit and deep care and love for the folks. Parishioners in Monville, Morristown, Ryanville, Brayton, the Cathedral, Waddington, Adler, Norfolk, Rainville, and the Tribunal, and Chancery staff. We could all add our own stories about Monsignor's his ministry. But we thank God for the just, plain goodness and approachability of this parish priest and church lawyer. May God reward him richly for a life so giving and so delightfully lived. The grain of wheat is fallen and dying. Continues to bear much fruit. We are confident that Monsignor will encounter no difficulty in approaching our merciful Savior. To Jean, Jim, Walter Lovelace, those are continued prayers for you at this time of sadness. To my brother priest, who walks together here forever. But haven't we all been blessed?
Last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
who have helped us, they may have the reward of their goodness. We pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother, may they be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who die by violence, war, and famine, show your mercy, Lord, to those who suffered so unjustly these sins against your goodness, and gather them into the eternal kingdom of your peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us, assembled here in worship and faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, may we never tire of turning to you in our need. We pray that you respond to these prayers, which we make as always, through Christ our risen Lord.
Thank you.
and minister here through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give thanks. Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has come, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, through your faith, the Lord, life has changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to God's name, eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so angels and archangels with the thrones and dominions and all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory.
Holy,
holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is he who comes in.
Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration. They may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. On the night he was betrayed, he took himself the bread, and giving you thanks, he said, blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, eat this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He made the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
The ministry of faith.
We proclaim your death,
O Lord.
Christ's resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to the second coming, we offer you with thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblations of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will reconcile us to yourself, grant we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an eternal inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, your spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Saint Andrew and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant, Francis, our Pope, and Terry, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people that you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all of your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Mary, whom you have called from this life to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you after passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever.
We await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
On your stay,
we joy in spirit of the Holy. Miserere nobis. On your stay, we joy in spirit of the Holy.
Thank you.
receive these sacraments of salvation, we implore your kindness, O God. For Monsignor Snow, your servant and priest, that as you named him as steward of your mysteries on earth, so you may bring him to be nourished by their truth and reality, as unveiled in heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a quick note of acknowledgement and information. First, you'll note on the back page of the program the directions to both Visitation Cemetery and also to the luncheon, which will follow our prayer at the cemetery. And so there is both a map and also a text of directions. We'd very much like to invite everyone to join us for this luncheon. And we're very grateful to the Norwood Council and the Norfolk Councils of the Knights of Columbus, and also to the ladies of the Altar and Rosary Societies of St. Andrews and the Visitation St. Raymond's, for hosting and providing this luncheon for family and friends and clergy. We also want to acknowledge and thank the fourth degree of the Knights of Columbus who provided the honor guard throughout yesterday afternoon and evening waiting for Monsignor Snow. And again, a word of thanks to Brian Plonka and the staff at the funeral home. As always, we thank Father Brian Stitt for his very capable coordination of our liturgies, and the seminarians who are assisting in service. Music is so much a part of our liturgy. We're very grateful to Lucas Gruber, a seminarian, being the organist, and Sloan Ryan as our cantor. A word of thanks to our priests and deacons. Someone made the comment that, boy, they're getting older looking. Folks, we may be getting older, but there is so much energy here. And we are blessed that these men take the time to travel, to pray with us, and to show the strength of our priestly fraternity, our fraternity with our brother deacons. So we thank you all very much. And finally, here's a word of thanks that maybe doesn't get spoken enough. It's the man with the hat over here. Bishop LaValle, certainly a very strong and pastoral presence for Harry these many years, especially as Harry began to get more and more limited because of his illnesses. And Bishop's care for the family and for all of us, we are very, very grateful.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Monsignor Harry Snow, now it is time for the last farewell. There is sadness and parting, and we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see him again and enjoy his friendship. Although we will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. And so let us console one another. Faith of Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
blessings which you have bestowed upon him in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant. Help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother forever. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you, to take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Whoever believes in me, even though that person die, shall live. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever lives and believes in me shall never die.
Peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.